Hopefully y'all can see me. I don't know how much me you can see, but hopefully it's enough. Me and my boy Cam, we about to go downtown, record. Who knows what, probably take some pictures and whatnot. I know he just got a GoPro, so we'll probably be taking photos of his car and some other things like that. But casual day, it's a Sunday, so we just gonna make the most of it. I actually see his car in my rear view. Hold on, let me see if I can get a good snap of it. There he is. That's that boy Babylonius. What's good, everybody? It's your boy Phantom Panda with the two P's in his name. We got a little hefty stack of comics right here that we're gonna go through. This will probably be at the end of the comic book vlog, but I don't really know how I want to edit this quite yet. But either way, I figured it might be nice to go through a little comic book collection, show y'all what I got. It's not a nice collection, it's not super valuable, super expensive, it just has some stuff I like in there. No full series, nothing like that, nothing crazy yet. But we are working on it, it is growing, so I mean, don't trip. I'll share my thoughts on some of these comics as I go through them and whatnot. But if y'all did enjoy the vlog so far and whatnot, make sure to give that a like, because I worked hard, I put in some work into it, and I think about 30-40% of y'all aren't actually subscribed. So if you are enjoying the video, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It don't cost you nothing, it supports your boy, and you get to see me every day. So make sure you think about supporting the channel, you know, hit a like, all that jazzy Jeff, share it with your friends. But let's get into this comic book collection. So the first one I got is actually not technically a comic. It's Evangelion, which I don't have very strong feelings for, like most of the fans do. I mean, it was alright, I guess. But it's actually just the manga, but in comic book form, which is interesting. I mean, I saw it for like, I think it was actually on Free Comic Book Day. It doesn't say it on here, but yeah, I'm pretty sure I got this because there's a free comic book day at our local comic shop, and I'm pretty sure this was my free comic for that day. But I mean, like, it's literally just the manga, but comic book format. Cool little pickup. It's published by Viz Comics, which, if y'all know Viz, y'all know. So, a little cool pickup. Nothing too special, nothing too crazy. I'm not super stoked about it. Our next one is actually a Valiant comic. Valiant? I said Valiant. Wow. Valiant comic. It is Bloodshot. I actually haven't read this one yet. I've opened it. It looked cool, which is the whole reason I bought it to begin with. But, it seemed interesting. So, I figured I'd pick up the first volume since it was there and it was cheap. And, And it's got some decent little art. I don't know how well y'all can see that. But I didn't spend too much on it. I think it was like $3. I picked this up a long time ago. I still haven't read it. But I'll probably do one of those things where I just like, I pick it up, I, you know, read it eventually, and if I like it, I'll buy more, and if I don't, then I just have it. This one is actually an Icon comic, which I don't have any more of these, just like Bloodshot. Picked these up on the same day. This is Hit Girl, which, doesn't seem super up my alley, I'm not gonna lie, but it caught my attention when I flipped through. Let me see if I can find an interesting panel. It's like this right here. Like, that looks like Kick-Ass. So I was like, okay, fuck it. Maybe this is something I'll be interested in. I don't really know. If y'all know about Hit Girl, let me know how you feel about it. I'm not gonna show what's on the back of this because it's actually pretty gory, and I like my videos staying on my channel, you feel me? Speaking of which, today's actually the 100th video I've uploaded. Valentine's Day, 100th video, and we're doing a vlog, so now you have to support the channel. 100 videos type beat. Show me my love. Show me my love. We're gonna go ahead and get into the next comic though. We have a few Street Fighter comics actually. All of these are published by Udon Comics. There's Street Fighter Unlimited, which I think is the actual series. I believe this is volume 4. Let's see. Yeah. So this is volume 4, issue 4, whichever one you want to call it. I believe this is one of the variant covers, but Juri's the main girl forever. I went the wrong way. Always got love for Juri. Never will stop having love for her. So I went ahead and picked this up. If I find more, I will pick up more. I haven't read it just because this isn't the first one. This is the fourth one. So I'd like to have the rest of those before I start reading. Our next comic, same publisher, same sort of genre, Street Fighter once again. It's Akuma vs. Hell. I did read this. This was sick as fuck. It does have Street Fighter V Akuma, which... iffy on that design, but I mean, it is what it is at the end of the day. The comic's cold, it's got some cool fights in it, and it's a just overall good read. I need to see if there's any more volumes, because this is only volume 1, and it felt like it had an open-ended ending, but I mean, we're gonna go ahead and show y'all. If y'all know, y'all know. That's all I got to say about that. If you know who that is. But we got one more? Yeah, one more Street Fighter comic. This one was actually a free book comic book day, and it says it up there, which is why I looked in the other one. Sakura vs. Karin, two of my favorite Street Fighter characters. I love them both to death. I like playing them both. But, I mean, the comics, they're like playing... what is that Street Fighter? Is it Puzzle Fighter? The Street Fighter Tetris game? They're just playing that in the comic. They're just doing like random competitions. They play different arcade games with each other and all kinds of stuff like that. And it's cool seeing like their personalities reflecting like a real world aspect. Because I believe, a lot of it's like, oh, you see Sakura pick Ryu for everything, because why wouldn't she? But Karin, of course, is going to pick herself, because it's Karin. But I mean, there's all kinds of crazy stuff. It's a decent little read. It was free, so, you know, I'm not bugging. I'm not complaining. And you're definitely about to see a big pile of comics back here. I'm just kind of slightly sorting them in separate piles back there, but it is what it is. Our next few comics are all Image comics, I believe, and they are all Spawn. If y'all don't know about Spawn, get hip right away. That's all I gotta say about that. We got Spawn 301. This is actually my first Spawn comic I ever read. And Spawn's probably one of my favorite comic book characters. Spawn is insane. I'm not gonna sit here and chew your head off with lore about this character, but how couldn't you like that? How couldn't you like that? Spawn is sick. Plus, on the back of this, they got... I believe this is... Todd McFarlane? Yeah, I believe that's his name. Basically, the artist who used to do Spider-Man went ahead and started his own comic book series, which was Spawn, and I like Spawn a lot. I really enjoy Spawn. This is Spawn number 1. These might be the compendium series. I'm not sure. I haven't actually read this one yet. I just picked it up because I saw it. Yeah, Todd McFarlane's his name. He does the story and the art for Spawn. We also have Witchblade and Spawn. I haven't done a lot of research on Witchblade, but Witchblade seems cool. I need to read it at some point, but I'll get around to it when I get around to it. I mainly picked this up because it was another Spawn comic and it was there. And then we got one more Spawn comic for y'all. This is Spawn number 12. This one's actually in the plastic protector with the... I forget what these are called. The little like white back piece. I used to... not work for a comic shop, but my family runs a comic shop, so I used to do a lot of ceiling comics like this. I just forget what these back protectors are called. Oops, I dropped my comic. Look, this is why I don't work at a comic book shop. I drop my own stuff. I'd probably drop someone else's. We got two Transformer comics right here. These are both in the same series. It is Heart of Darkness, which is made by IDW. If y'all don't know about IDW, get hip right away, because IDW makes some fire comics. I haven't actually read either of these, but I do have insane amounts of love for Transformers and the series in general. I really don't fuck with what Michael Bay did to the series, but I mean, it is what it is at the end of the day. This is number one, this is number four. But they used the original designs in this comic. I did flip through it, and I do like that. It also looks like there's a lot of new stuff going on in this series, so could be interesting. Could be really interesting. And then we got a decent little pile of some more IDW comics. Marvel and DC are last. I know y'all are waiting for those. They're here. They're just at the bottom of this pile. So for the next set of IDW comics, if you didn't expect this, I'm baffled beyond belief. We have the Sonic the Hedgehog IDW run. I don't have any Archie Sonic comics. I have read them. I don't own physical copies. Y'all won't see that here, but I do have a decent amount of the IDW comics. Let's go ahead and go through those numbers. We got 1, 23, 28, which y'all saw me pick up in the video, 31, and 32. I really do enjoy this storyline a lot. I just need to go ahead and start searching for more. I've seen them on Amazon and other websites that sell comics. I just haven't bought them because I don't like the idea of buying comics online and shipping them out. I feel like that's a good way to get them torn up. I mean, y'all see the manga shelf back there. I bought most of those online, but manga's a little more durable than comic books are, so we'll see. I don't know, but let's go ahead and get into DC, because DC is a pretty big chunk of this pile. I will give you a disclaimer right now. I am forever Team DC over Team Marvel. I do enjoy a lot of Marvel characters and Marvel stories. My favorite Marvel characters are Moon Knight, Ghost Rider, but DC's where that joint is. I also really like Silk. I wasn't gonna say Spider-Man because I feel like you gotta specify one is Spider-Man, but you know, whatever. We have The Signal, which is actually a comic I got from my homie Kami. He bought this comic and he gave it to me. I haven't read it quite yet, but I do plan on it. And if y'all have been keeping up with DC, you know that they're doing the Future State comic run right now, and I have quite a bit of those, and I've really been enjoying the Future State stories. Right here we have Superwoman 1 and 2. I've read the first volume. I went back and bought the second one the day it came out, but I have not read it yet. I need to go ahead and read that, pick up the rest of it. And then we have Harley Quinn 1 and 2 as well. Also, I've read the first one, haven't read the second one, but I am interested in the storyline. I like where it's going. And Future State's just a sick idea in general. I mean, of course, comics always reboot and whatnot, but just the sheer wealth of stories they can give out with these reboots is kind of promising. Wonder Woman number one, this is a variant cover. I don't have the original one, which doesn't really bother me. I'm not super interested in this Wonder Woman story, so I don't really care to have like the original cover or anything like that. We have right here Teen Titans, which I do want to go actually get the original cover for if I can find it, because my boy Red X is back here, and if y'all know me, y'all know I like Red X. But the Teen Titans run is interesting. I believe it ties in with Red Hood's story too, which we also have sitting right here and we will get into. But Teen Titans is nice. I've only read about half of this, but I do plan on getting back to it at some point. And then we have Red Hood right here. Of course, you know I had to pick this up. Red Hood's one of my favorite DC characters. And we actually have more Red Hood comics right under that. If y'all know about Red Hood Outlaws, y'all are in for a treat, because that is my joint. My love for comics. Red Hood Outlaws, I don't know, this is volume 4. We have volume 15, 27. Look, I got it wrong. I thought this one was 15. But I love this cover. Y'all can see it kind of reflects and whatnot. Even the back of this reflective. Fuck Legos for real. But Red Hood Outlaws, amazing storyline. I have read through all this. I'm just going ahead and getting my physical copies when I can and when I find them. But it's a growing collection, you know, I'll get there eventually. It's nothing I'm in a rush for. Next set of comics is Deathstroke, one of my favorite villains in DC, and I don't know which numbers these are. This one's 15. I knew I was bugging somewhere. And this one's 11. I fuck with both of these comics. They're really interesting stories. Deathstroke's just a cool character to me in general, and don't let the shows or the games fool you. That motherfucker is a menace. Next we have the Blackest Night comic. I believe this is volume 1, which I need to go ahead and, or yeah, right there. I don't know if y'all are gonna be able to see it, but issue number 1. Blackest Night is one of my favorite Green Lantern comic storylines in general. I think it's one of the coolest storylines they've ever had come out of Green Lantern, and it's just overall an entertaining read. Let me see if I can find a cool panel for y'all that doesn't involve blue aliens of some kind. But basically, the Blackest Night are this. The Blackest Night is, wow, my grammar sucks, is a storyline about all these characters being brought back as zombies due to getting their hands on Black Lantern rings, and it's insane. It's a crazy ride. I enjoy it for what it is so far, and I need to go ahead and find the rest if I can. Next up, we have the Batman Beyond Rebirth comics. I really love Batman Beyond. That was my childhood. I even have it sitting under my desk right now. But Batman Beyond is my love, my cocaine for Batman. And we have Volume 1, Volume 2 right here, and haven't actually read this one, but it's entertaining. I like it so far. It is a unique storyline. It's not exactly what you'd expect out of Batman Beyond, and I think that's part of what pulls me in for it. This was another comic I got on Free Comic Book Day. Most people know about the Batman Who Laughs. I don't have to tell you what his backstory is or anything like that. But I do have my hands on it, and that's what really matters. I have a hold of that Batman Who Laughs, and I need more. I need it. This story is so good. I need it bad. And next up, our last two DC comics are both Death of the Family comics. We have 14 and I believe this is 16. Yep. So, you know, if you know about Batman, you know about Death of the Family. I don't have to go into it. If you don't know about it and you have HBO Max, you can watch the movie. My apologies. I definitely just hit the mic. Y'all can watch the movie. You know, like, treat yourself to some Death of the Family. I promise you, y'all will enjoy it. Now let's go ahead and get into the Marvel stack, because that one's also somewhat hefty, but not anywhere near as big as the DC pile was. First up, we have my very first comic book I ever owned. I got this in elementary school, I believe. And this was actually a gift from my relative who runs the comic book shop, and I got it for free. I read it. I was like, oh, this is sick. And I mean, you know, it's a Spider-Man comic. There's not a lot I can say about it. I mean, I was young. This comic book is, I wouldn't say it's old, but like, look at this. Like, you have Batman in Marvel Comics. Like, that should tell you a lot about when I got a hold of this comic. Did my face cam just freeze? Hello? Hello? Y'all might think I'm bugging if it didn't freeze for you, but it froze for me. But it's an older comic. I can't find a page that doesn't have an ad on it. So yeah, that's how you know, like, y'all can't really feel the texture of the paper, but you can feel that it's an older comic. I mean, it's kind of yellowing at the top, and there's ads almost like every three or four pages, so that should say a lot about it. Right after that, we have Ghost Rider 1 and 2, which is, I believe, just like the main run for the Ghost Rider storyline. I'm not entirely sure, but I've only read Volume 1. I picked up both of them because I wanted to read this volume, but I felt like I needed to read the first one beforehand, so I have them both, and I'll get around to it when I get around to it. Next up, though, is my favorite Ghost Rider storyline, the Cosmic Ghost Rider. And if y'all haven't heard of this, I'm not going to spoil who the Ghost Rider is or anything about it, but the storyline does involve Ghost Rider, of course, him being a cosmic being. Beaning? Wow. A cosmic being. He's hunting down Thanos in most of this, and there's not a lot I can really say about it, but definitely treat yourself. I'm looking for more volumes of this because I've only been able to find the physical copy of one, but it's a good read. I definitely would recommend. And y'all can trust Panda recommendations. I give out the good ones. Next up, we have Silk. I believe y'all saw me pick this up and buy it in the vlog. I'd have to look back. I haven't edited it yet, of course, but I did pick up another Silk comic. I love Silk as a character. Always will love Silk as a character, and she's really cool to me. I need to go buy more of her comics, but I have read bits and pieces of them, and this will be another one of my read eventually. Following up on the Silk, there is also this one. This is a lot thicker. It's like an actual book, damn near. But more Silk comics, I mean, not a lot to say. Black Cat's in this too, which, more for me, more interesting storylines to go about. But I'll read it when I read it, and it'll just be something to get around to. Now lastly, for the comic book collection, this was actually a Christmas gift if I'm not mistaken, but we have this big hefty Deadpool comic book, which is a collection of multiple Deadpool comics. Like, look, like the meme of Thanos looking down. That it's in here somewhere. I don't know if I'd be able to flip to it that easily. I know it's towards the end, but there's all kinds of crazy stuff. Give me a second. We'll find it. Here we go. I finally found the page. Y'all see it right there for yourself. That's a weird angle, I know, but y'all gonna have to hold that. I didn't want to hit the camera. And even that storyline itself is, it's insane. It's funny. I've read almost all of this. It's a really good read. So definitely treat yourself to some Deadpool today if you haven't already. Even if it's the movie, treat yourself. Anyways, that's going to be all from Panda. Happy Valentine's Day to you all. Till the next time, Panda's peace and out. Later.